Strong going to look to throw it right off the bat. That's complete to his tight end, Seals Jones. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Well, this game, the ninth that the Jags have played here in London, you might know that Shad Khan, he's the owner of both the Jaguars and Fulham in the English Premier League on the soccer side of things. And this is the third of 3 London games the NFL will play this year. But there is one more game to come over on the continent, the Seahawks and Bucks from Munich, Germany. The first time a regular season game will be played there. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. So now an early 3rd and 10 here on their opening drive. Operating from the gun. Strong. Man open. He's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. So opening drive, 3rd down. They complete the slant to move the sticks.
And ordinarily, it's a high percentage pass when you throw it. And receivers like to run that route because it gets the ball in their hands pretty quickly. Just a couple of quick steps upfield, break towards the middle, the ball should be there, and then they can get to do some work afterwards.
And he's dropped right at the 40, gain of 3. Well, this defense for the Jaguars, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball? Or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 44-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. A give to Drake running left. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked up by Andre Sisco. And the Jags are going to get the football here at their own 23. Time will tell if that's an interception that rattles the rookie here. First drive on the road.
And you know the discussion going into the game? Centered on, okay, let's get out nice and easy. Take care of the football. We're on the road. You're a youngster. Let's not make mistakes early. But now the conversation will shift to, okay, put it behind you. Move on. Long way to go in this one.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw here taken in by Ingram. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Lawrence. That's caught on the left side by Kirk. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that'll bring up 2nd down. The Jaguars sitting at 5-2 on the year. And they come in on a good run, winners of 5 of their last 7.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
They'll run for the first time with Travis Etienne. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 43. The tight end in motion right. Play action. It's Lawrence. And looking for Cook, but this pass is intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apkin. And the Broncos will take over possession here up at the 44. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it was a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. He shows you right there, he can do more than just cover in the secondary from that free safety position.
Yeah, the evolution of position has really been significant, hasn't it? Because a lot of teams no longer have a free safety, strong safety designation. They just have safeties. So wherever the ball is, one can be close to the line of scrimmage, one can be deep, and vice versa. On that play, how about that tackle we just saw? Pretty nice.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Throw to the right, caught by Dulcich. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. Third down, here's Cannon, and he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up third downs in the top five in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I'm guarantee you, it started in the offseason. Third down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
On first and 10, Strong. He finds Sutton crossing the formation complete. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one, the man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. The gun. They'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's going to be caught along the sideline, and what a job of keeping his feet in bounds. They say that's a catch. Rookie to rookie on the hook up there, and it's a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down in bounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Play action. Strong. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Rookie Seals Jones. His first touchdown on the year. And Broncos use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Extra point from McManus is good, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. From the six. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
But give them credit for a good read right there because they read the man coverage on the right side and sent the tight end a few steps down the field and then angled him to the left on a crossing route. He was able to get enough separation on this play to turn it into a nice gain.
They go play action with Lawrence. Completes it to Evan Engram. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. And in two plays just like that, they're already operating in the red zone.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Straight ahead, ETN. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team. Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Another toe for ETN, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It's an 8 yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. Lawrence on the sneak, and he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. His third rushing touchdown of the year, his fifth overall. And the Jaguars are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded right around the 8. The Broncos onto the field ready to start their next drive. And they entered play on a two-game win streak, and then they've got the open date on their schedule next week. So this is a group that's really looking to hit the break on a high note.
And this will obviously be a tough game for them, but go ahead and play this out with me, partner. If they win here and make it 3 in a row, they get to heal up after that. You've got to think that's an ideal setup and a worthy goal to play for in this one. And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Looking to throw on second down. Strong. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Yeah, This offense so far on third down, a perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Back to throw. Strong. Gets it to his running back, Cannon. So the completion good for just 3. And it's 2nd down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
To throw on 2nd down. Strong. A pass for Sutton is intercepted. It's Devin Lloyd with a pick, and the Jaguars are going to take possession of the football.
I believe this is what you would call growing pains here, Parker, because this defense obviously took the challenge facing the rookie, and they wanted to help indoctrinate him to the NFL. So now the big question is, can he answer that challenge and rebound with plenty of time remaining in this game?
They'll run it. This is James Robinson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator. Yeah.
A give running right, ETN. Room here to run. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 47 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled him with the inside run.
Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
A 1-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Crossing right, and he hits his man. It's Jones. And this is going to be another 1st down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 12-yard line. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. And they'll send the slot in motion left. On 1st and 10, it's Robinson. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 1st half. All knotted up, it's 7. Second and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? ETN up the middle. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Here's Lawrence to throw. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps a field goal on the table as it's fourth down. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had. Thought they could exploit them. Unable to do so on that play.
So he's been automatic to this point in the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Fielded right around the eight. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Here comes another drive from this unit, and Charles, they're coming off a costly mistake on the last possession, an interception in a game that is very close right now.
Well, as we know, they all sting no matter what the situation, but in a one-possession game, that'll hurt a little bit more. But this is an excellent opportunity to make up for it on this drive. I just don't expect them to try and take huge gambles to make up that momentum in a hurry.
Looking to throw on second down. Strong. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So that, another sack for the first-round pick on the season. You know, he's shown here, Charles, in the first few months of his career that pass rushing, it might be a specialty of his.
Yeah, and I'm not sure that I graded him that way prior to the season. That's not necessarily what they drafted him for at all, but let's face it, they're going to take it, and I think they'll expand upon these talents that they found and keep sending him after the quarterback.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. It just appeared there that the defense, they had that read from the moment the ball was snapped. And not only did they get the interception, add a nice return on top of it, all the way into the end zone for a defensive touchdown.
Yeah, and the guy made the play. He gets the points. But it really was a group effort, wasn't it? How about the coaches? They've got to be so excited. All the preparation, time in the film room, it translated into a big play that put points on the board for their team.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This one fielded at the five. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
Back to the air on second down. Strong. And his throw here is incomplete.
With a rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Operating from the gun, Strong. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
Back to throw again. And incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Again, he'll drop to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cannon. Now the Broncos will use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
They'll look to throw again. Now he's going to let it go deep, right sideline. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
So 1 first down on that drive, and that's it. Forced to take the deep shot on 3rd down and couldn't hit it. Now they have to punt this one away.
So on 4th down, the Broncos send Corliss Waitman out to punt. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one hears away. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Already enjoying a 2-score lead here late in the 2nd quarter. Not a ton of time left. We'll see if they can work this at least into field goal range and try to get 3 to add on even more to their lead. On 1st down, Lawrence. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That could have been a huge play, but give the defender credit. Stayed calm, stayed collected, and kept himself in a position to make a play on the ball without a penalty.
To throw again on 2nd down. Lawrence, he'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a 1st down as well.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Here's Lawrence. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's 2nd down.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. He'll get this off DTN. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
On third down, Lawrence. And Ingram hauls it in. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from 53. Badgley's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. A play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence. That's out wide here for Robinson. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. A handoff for ETN. And he's got some space here. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to an even 20. Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. Takes it at the 7. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They go play action here on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Tyree Gillespie.
And the Jags are going to take possession of the football.
Boy, Charles, you hate to see this for a rookie quarterback. You're hoping it doesn't shake his confidence, but that confidence, it might be shaken because that is four interceptions for him now in this ballgame.
It has to be shaken. Wouldn't be human if you weren't. Doesn't matter whether you're a rookie or a veteran, four interceptions, you're not sure what you're doing out there. So to me as a coaching staff, I would think very hard about getting him out and trying it again another day. I'm seeing a lot of guys shaking their heads on defense right now, particularly in the secondary. And when you see that going on, that is never a good sign. But it's understood.
And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. James Robinson with his fourth rushing touchdown of the year. And the Jaguars are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that stretches the lead all the way up to 27. Touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away. From the six. Onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Off the play fake. Strong. Able to hook up with Williams here on the out route. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple. And it's second down.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
Behind the chain, second and 12. Play action. Strong. Sutton reeling it in on the left side. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 35. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll get it to Drake, running left.
And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down. Well, this defense, they've got the 4-score advantage, and you can see why. They continue to bottle up the run game, and really they've just been sharp in all facets here in this one, CD.
Yeah, they've kept that offense in check the entire game, and I think it's been led by what you just talked about, that defensive front, which has not allowed them to run the football and establish control of the line of scrimmage.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Looking to throw. Strong. That's taken in by Dulcich. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 14. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Up the middle they go with Drake. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
You got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
A rare misstep on that last play, because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Back to throw. Strong. On the slant, completes to Sutton. And the Broncos are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Williams will take it in. Touchdown, Denver.
Did my eyes deceive me, or was that an eye formation play that was just run there for a touchdown?
Little old school eye.
How about that? Was that a fullback, tailback, running it into the end zone?
Well, that's what that fullback's for, right? That's why you use that. Let him pave the way.
Oh, without a doubt. He's an extra blocker, and he did his job well on that play.
McManus's point after is good, and the lead now down to 20. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin 1st and 10. Now ETN to start the drive. And some space here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 141 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Play action. It's Lawrence. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Another 1st down there as this one goes for 25. Here's a give to ETN. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. 2nd down coming up.
Nice chunk of yards on 1st down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on 2nd. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
final minute now of the third quarter. On second down, ETN once more. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four.
Back-to-back four-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now third and two, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. They'll run with ETN. And this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we'll begin it with a field goal try here. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. Badgley able to punch this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. So they get the three. It was fourth and one, and I think you were doing what I was doing. I was looking down at the sideline. I'm not sure the offensive unit wanted the three. They wanted to go for it.
But when have we ever seen a unit that didn't want to go for it in that situation?
That's true.
Right? Sometimes it's just way more important to have the points on the board than to worry about any type of a gamble.
From the six. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. Throwing on first down. Strong. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion, and they're just a little over 100 yards passing here in this game. So defensively, pretty good job.
Definitely, because they were never really able to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers. So a lot of credit to the defensive game plan and especially the execution.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Again, Strong. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And my goodness, another interception. And the Jaguars are going to take over at their own 41. Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, five interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough. But, man, this defense, they have been ball-hawking and impressive. But, Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard, but also you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game. So you have to know your player, you have to know the situation. That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
And we're at the 41, second and 9. Lawrence, now this is ETN on the draw. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. 160 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues. The Jaguars on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Yeah, they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. It's a gain of a yard, and the Jags are going to have a first down. Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. Here's Robinson again on second down. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Lawrence now off the bootleg. They'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 21 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Second down and a run by Robinson. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. They'll try and run. This is Robinson. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
They'll try to run with Robinson. He needed three, he got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard.
This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put six on the board.
So the defense are able to force the interception, and the offense working their way to field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they couldn't get exactly what they wanted, which was a touchdown, they did get 3 points out of it. So they paid off what the defense gave them. Both sides to be thrilled with that.
After the made field goal, Badgley back out there for the kickoff. Montrell Washington on the return from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. A throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Throwing again on second and 10. Strong. And to the right side here, it's Allen. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Looking to throw. Strong. And now here's another interception. Picked up by Andre Sisco. And the Jags are going to take possession of the football.
Well, this is something we've seen before, partner. We've seen a defense bait a rookie, pretend to leave a window open, and then the defensive back jumped it as soon as the ball was released. Big time play. They love taking advantage of the youngsters. And in this case, it paid off well.
Faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends, and understandably so. Not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ball game.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on all those high-end sports cars, what's the top gear you can get into. This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for the Jaguars,
they climb to 6-2 on the year as they close in on the midpoint of this 17-game schedule.
And now it's off to Heathrow as they get set to fly back to the U.S. in a couple hours. Meanwhile, for Denver, they fall 2 games under .500 now at 3-5. And they'll take this loss into the bye as they'll be back in action in Week 10.
Trust. Truthfully, we envy, so why we so envious? And why our own kind envy us? Pac said it's hard, but we gotta keep our head up. Going even though.